Hello everyone, welcome again to Inspiration Academy. Hope you are enjoying your new year and Christmas leave. Everyone has a new resolution on coming new year that what should they do. So we are introducing today and we can hope we can help you to learn new skills, which is called cloud and Python and information security. So today we will help you to clear doubts which everyone has, like, will my job will be stable if I am a network engineer or a software engineer? Will it help? What should I do the next? Should I move into cloud, or should I do anything which can help me to stay in my current organization while developing my skill? So today we will be talking about AWS, how it can help you to grow your career, and what all things can be beneficial. So here you go. So in AWS, or either it's a Microsoft Azure, both are offering their infrastructure service as a business, and both are in heavily demand right now. So both are known as cloud computing. So one of the key benefits which you can see on the screen is you need to replace your upfront capital, that is your infrastructure expenses which you are paying for your hardware. You don't want to pay more. You want your infrastructure to be managed in the cloud and want it to be secure. So with the cloud introduction, whether it's a Microsoft Azure or AWS cloud, business no longer need a plan for procuring servers or IT infrastructure weeks. So what are the main benefits of cloud computing? So basically, it can cover trade capital expense for variable expense, benefit from massive economics of scale, no guessing about capacity. You can upgrade your hardware, RAM, CPU, unlimited, depends on your capability, depends on your customer business, depend on your IT service. It will increase your speed, agility. You don't need to spend money running and maintaining your data centers. And you can configure your configuration in minutes. It does not take time. So that's why most of the big organizations are currently moving into cloud. So people have questions like, if they are a network engineer, which type of certifications they should do in the cloud and how it will benefit in their interviews or careers. So first of all, you need to know about basics of cloud before moving into either AWS or Azure or Google Cloud. You need to know that what are the main three models which are provided on the cloud, and what are the main two deployment modules which you can cover in the cloud. So people, we can see that there are three main modules and or models which can be covered in the cloud. First one is infrastructure as a service. Second one is a platform as a service. And third one is a software as a service. And suppose you are running hardware and you first need to migrate into hybrid cloud. Rather than moving totally into cloud, you want some critical service on your hardware, on your data center, and some less critical service you move into cloud, that is called hybrid, which is there in the cloud computing deployment modules. First one is cloud, second one is hybrid, which is a combination of both on-premises versus cloud infrastructure. So what is the benefit? Now we need to discuss about what all benefits can be provided when moving into cloud. So first and most important term which comes into mind is security and compliance. Every customer will ask whether my data will remain safe, whether it's a financial institutes or it's a banking sector or is it IT sector. All other people and teams and customer take care of security. So benefits of AWS security is it keeps your data safe. It keeps your data according to the compliance, whether it's a PCI DSS, it's a ISO standard, and it will save your money. It is scalability. So AWS or either other cloud services, for them, the key point is security. They guarantee you that. They provide you security. Even I agree that there would be some attacks and hackers are aware that what are the weaknesses. Since they are introduced and they are improving, so they have introduced different services, which we will discuss. Like in Palo Alto, they have wildfire features. In AWS, they have other features which will benefit you. How to protect from zero-day attacks. Security would be covered in the cloud. And how AWS will help or either other cloud would help to cover compliance. So they are focusing on that also. They are following SOC standards, which are called SOC 1, SOC 2, SOC 3. All comes under auditing. All your banking and financial departments would cover in PCI DSS. And other companies covering ISO standards. So how, what are the topics which you need to know and which Inspiration Academy will be covering? So basically the services which AWS or other cloud provides are compute services. First one, storage, database, networking, where we talk about VPC, virtual private cloud, regions, domains, building IPsec, VPNs, and other things. And developer tools, which will help you to develop your languages, application language. Your database would cover your database services when they talk with web application servers. Then we talk about security, identity, and compliance. Either it can be your identity access management, or it can be your application services, or it can be your Skype application messaging services, which you need to move into cloud. So these are the main benefits in the cloud, and they are providing you as a service. So there are main services which other topics would cover are management console. So like in Checkpoint, they have a management server and gateway server. Like in AWS, they have a management console, which is a web application for managing your AWS. You can do any configuration you want using management console. Same as management console, AWS give you a CLI interface where you can manage your AWS service. You can configure, you can download multiple scripts, you can control multiple AWS service from the cloud. You can configure it and you can automate through scripts. Another important thing is software development kits, how they can help. So since all applications are moving into API, which is called Application Program Interface, AWS SDKs will simplify it. It will help you to build your application quickly in 1 minute. And the topics which we will be covering related to service are compute service, where we will discuss about EC2, Elastic Pen Stack, Lambda, and auto scaling. Then we talk about storage. See, as a network admin or of a network security, first certification or first knowledge preference would be to have a AWS associate level knowledge. It's like a CCNA. If you compare, I can say it to be compared with CCNA level. Then you need to decide whether you are a developer or you are a network engineer or you are a security engineer, you can proceed accordingly. But for everyone, they should first understand what are the different models, what are the deployment models, and how I can deploy. So we will cover all practical stuff. We will cover basically related to cloud, storage, database, Elastic File System, how we can integrate AWS with database, either it can be a Mango database, Elastic Cache, RDS. And if you talk about networking, load balancing, we will cover in networking and content delivery. Either it can be virtual private cloud, Route 53, which generally manage for DNS solution, load balancing. So everything is there in cloud, which you are right now doing in multiple devices. So what's the another advantage is it's a single management console where you can manage your network, security, database, and other services. If you talk about developer tools, it covers your code deployment, code pipelining, X-ray, and other services. And if you talk about security, identity and compliance, we will cover these topics. Like in Windows, it's called Active Directory. Here it's concept called as Cloud Directory. Then we will cover identity and access management stuff, where you will get to know that how you can protect your users, groups, and other things, how you integrate your AD database, and how you can keep it secure. We will cover AWS Shield, which is also an important topic, which will tell you how you can protect it. Then there is an AWS WAF also, which is called Web Application Firewall. See, everyone is moving into cloud. It does not mean that you don't need to know the basic knowledge. People are still needed. It's just that you have to grow your skills. Then we will talk about application service, how APIs are built, how you can deploy application quickly. And there are other topics for messaging, which is called SQS and SIANETS and SES. So now the important question comes, as a network point of view or network engineer, why I should learn AWS? What advantage it will give you to my current organization, or if I can interview any other organization? People, if you look over the jobs, people are asking for AWS and Python programming along with your load balancer skills, your other skills like firewalls. They still want you to know about AWS or any other cloud infrastructure. They want you to hire and migrate. So that's why you need to understand. So we have discussed about this previously, like what all advantages they can offer related to AWS. Flexibility, pricing, global architecture, security, compliance, backup, scheduling, reliability, and API deployment. Another thing is network engineers are worried what advantage they can get from cloud, how it will benefit them. So basically, if you know that network engineers, what are they doing? Right now, they are either operations, SOC, security operation centers, network operation centers. They deploy the network on the hardwares, whether it's a switch, router, load balancer, firewalls, to communicate between different networks. So Gail, basically the goal here is to ensure the integrity of high availability network to provide maximum performance. So according to this definition, a network engineer is trying to move into cloud, then one thing must be clear, that there is no prior work for network engineer. If a person is moving to cloud, then he should gain self skills, like how to design your environment, how to develop it, and how to deploy your cloud service. So as an Inspiration Academy, we would suggest you to start with AWS Solution Architect Associate. That will help you to understand deploy overall structure service of AWS. It's like a CCNA level, and after that, it depends upon you. Once you cleared this exam, you have a knowledge, then I would suggest either to go to SysOps Associate, or you can go to AWS Network Security Specialist, or you can go to AWS Security Certification. Then, after you have a good knowledge, you have deployed it, then we would suggest you to go to AWS Networking Specialist Professional Services. So we would help you to clear all your doubts, all live exposure. We will show you what all challenges one can get when they move into cloud and how you can get rid of this. So anyone who is interested, they can contact us on email ID mentioned on screen. Hope you like this video. Any doubts, you can comment. Thank you, everyone. Have a nice day.